So now that we have an algorithm for computing the Kolesky factorization, we can go back to the Kolesky factorization theorem and sort of think through what is it that we need to do. Well, notice that the first step of the algorithm works because we can prove that alpha 1 is a positive real number, and therefore we can take its square root, and at that point everything is prescribed in the current step. The only catch is that it must again be the case that this updated matrix is itself again a Hermitian positive definite matrix, because only then is it the case that once we update it, we can once again do the next step, and the next step, and the next step. Okay? So we can summarize all of that as a little lemma. We can say lemma. If A is Hermitian positive definite, and A can be partitioned as alpha 1 1, A 2 1, A 2 1 Hermitian transpose A 2 2, and we define L 2 1 to be equal to A 2 1 divided by the square root of alpha 1 1, namely this lambda 1 1 right here, then A22 minus L21 times L21 Hermitian transpose is Hermitian positive definite. If we can prove that, then you can kind of see how the proof by induction falls in place. Right. So, let me erase all of this and then let's prove this right here. So before we do this proof, let's just notice that this is just A22 minus A21, A21 Hermitian transpose divided by alpha 1, 1. Okay, so we need to prove that that's Hermitian positive definite. All right, so here goes the proof. To show that a matrix is Hermitian positive definite, we need to show that if you hit it on the left and right with a non-zero vector, then the result is always greater than zero. So, pick x2, that's not a zero vector. We need to show that x2 Hermitian transpose times A22 minus A21, A21 Hermitian transpose over alpha 1, 1 times x2 is greater than zero. Okay, now the way we're going to do that is we're going to create a new vector x that is equal to chi 1 x2, and we're going to show, well, we know that obviously this is not the zero vector because one of its parts is not the zero vector, and therefore we know that zero is less than x Hermitian transpose ax. Now, what we want to do is we want to pick our chi 1 in such a way that when we work through all of this, this pops out so that we can conclude that it's greater than zero. And the key is to pick our chi 1 just right. So to get to the point where we can pick our chi 1 just right, we're going to have to push through a little bit, and then we're going to have to scratch our head, and then we're going to have to be clever. All right, so let's see what comes out. Well, this here is just equal to chi 1 x2 Hermitian transpose times the partition matrix alpha 1 1 A21 A21 Hermitian transpose A22 times chi 1 x2. And if you multiply all of that out, well, let's see, the first step is to say, okay, let's leave this alone, and let's multiply this out. Let's see, the top becomes alpha 1 1 chi 1 plus A 2 1 Hermitian transpose times x 2, and the bottom becomes A 2 1 times chi 1 plus A 2 2 times x 2. That's the factor. And if you then work that out, what you get is this times that. We need to take the Hermitian transpose of chi 1. So, well, we don't know yet if that's actually real valued, so let's just keep going. But we can write this as alpha 1 1 times chi 1 Hermitian, well, it's really conjugate, right? Times chi 1. So notice that that's the square of the absolute value plus chi 1 conjugate times, let's see, a 2 1 Hermitian times x 2. Plus, let's see, alpha 1 1 times chi 1 times x 2, that's this times that with a Hermitian on it. Wait a second, we need to do this times that, so hold on. We get x 2 Hermitian a 2 1, and we can bring our chi 1 to the front. And then we can do x2 Hermitian a22 times x2. Right? Okay. And now it comes down to trying to be clever. Okay? We want somehow this whole thing to equal x2 Hermitian times the quantity a22 minus a21 Hermitian over alpha 1 1 times x2. Okay? And if we work that out, that means that all of this needs to boil down to x2 Hermitian a22 x2 minus x2 Hermitian a21 times a21 Hermitian x2 divided by alpha 1 1. Right? Now, if you compare and contrast these things, what if we pick the negative of x2 times a21, let's say x2 Hermitian transpose a21 to be our chi1? Then we get pretty close, because then this here becomes exactly this except multiplied by alpha 1 1 and so forth. So maybe what we want to do is divide by alpha 1 1, and lo and behold, if you take that chi 1 and you plug it in everywhere up here, then you actually get exactly this. Because, let's see, one of these terms ends up becoming exactly this, and the other term ends up canceling this term right here. Work it out. So the point is, given our x2, which is arbitrarily chosen, we can carefully construct a new vector that we can then use with A, and then knowing that A is Hermitian positive definite, that allows us to work out that this matrix right here, which is the matrix that we're after, is also Hermitian positive definite. So this kind of gives us all the pieces, and then you have to put it together into a proof by induction. And we give all of the details of that in the proof in this union.